Hello, welcome everyone to the official YouTube channel of ISBR Business School. Here's another video for you guys in the series of Expert Matters. So we have Racy Shukla amongst us. Welcome, Racy. We are so glad to have you.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Let me just quickly start by introducing her. We have Racy Shukla with us from a background of working as a counselor and doing her dream job to following her passion. She has thousands and beyond stories of her experience to share with us today. She has an experience of different high altitude treks with so many reputed organizations. And she got the opportunity to work as a liaison officer with an USA All Women Expedition. Currently, she's working with Bike It Adventures in India. She plans, organizes, and handles a team in difficult times. So we are so glad to have you today. Can you just start sharing your experience with our viewers?
Hi, Shruti. Thank you so much. Sharing my experience, I'll start with, from a corporate counseling coming to trekking, becoming a trek leader was a long journey. I went to my very first trek that was in Siachen Glacier. The peace and the serenity and the minimalistic life, I would say, I loved it so much that I did my courses then back to back. I did my basic, advanced and search and rescue and started working as a trek leader. I love my work as of now because I meet different people from different startup coming to that one trek together and going through high altitude in that worst conditions, worst weather, and coming back as a team. So yeah, I like managing that team. You know, they're different people, different mindset, but they have to stay together because they're stuck.
Yes. So you know that you are doing a job, you are becoming a role model of all the women who are working hard to sustain and survive in their career, who are struggling to make a career decision. And also you will be a role model. You are already a role model for women empowerment in our Indian society. So what do you think about women empowerment in Indian society?
Women empowerment again is a very vague term, but I can just say about my field. In my field, there are very few women trek leaders.
Yes, exactly.
I would say even when I went for my very first job interview, after the interview, I was asked this, like, how will you cope up being a woman in this male dominated field? Mm-hmm. That made me feel bad. You know, you are telling this line to the person who has come to, want a job in your company. So I didn't take that job for sure. But then I changed my companies. But right now, the company I work in, thankfully, I have a very good job environment. I've never felt like a woman in this company. You know, everything is equal. So this, I would say, women empowerment is where you don't have to feel that you are. I am a trek leader. Everything is same. For male or female, I am a trek leader. So there you feel empowered. You know, nobody questioning you, judging you. Whatever decision I make, everybody has to follow. My team, my staff, just because I'm a trek leader, not a male and a female. So for me, that is it. I feel totally empowered.
That is a great thing. That is an amazing thing, actually, surviving in a male dominated culture and in a job which is so challenging. You are making a big way ahead. And also, so do you think there is a dissimilarity or a not equal balance amongst male and women in our society?
Yeah, true. You can see, I would say that people coming for my tricks also. Mm-hmm. Male young crowd is more than female because the family is not allowed. And even after marriage, now the husband is not allowing, husband was coming for trek. For everything you have to ask, right? There's an ask. But for male, it is not there. They can come anytime on trek. They might not even tell their family. And even after marriage, they come without their wife, saying ki wo survive nahi kar payegi. I don't know if they ask them or not, but that is a very common thing. So yeah, I can see discrepancies here only. You know, we have to ask. Even for a trek, we'll have to ask, and family might say, ki, how will you stay there? Tents mein kiske saath rahoge? Kaise survive karoge? Kaun hoga aapke saath? You know, we are judged. In my field, I can see that.
Yes, exactly. So do you have an experience to share regarding the same?
Yeah, like I said, there are many boys group, they come. Same college and the married people. Mm-hmm. And for them, college wale, they're saying ki girlfriend kahan aayegi, why? Ki to hum usi ko utha ke leke chalte rahenge ya usi ka bag uthate rahenge. And same for the married men, they'll be like, ki, wo kahan paayegi, ghar kaun samale, ghar kaun samalega. So they can come and enjoy here, but you know, wife, unko to ghar samale.
So do you think there is a hope for change or not? Can we see a positive response in the mentality of Indians in near future?
Yeah, the same time, there are many people who are coming with their families, taking their wife. If even if their wife do camp tak ki ja rahi hai, at least they're bringing her. For her, it's the first time. So there was this one couple in my last trip, in the husband, he pehle bahut risk kiya, but now he got his wife this time. She could go only till second camp, but at least she came. And now she's happy and she will come again, more prepared. Because until now, she didn't know how the high trek means, what is high altitude, but now she knows. So this is conditioning. A hope starting to change. People bringing them. and when the young girls coming, telling their family and going back safe, they will also know, okay, trekking is safe. It's not something you're going into like totally wilderness. There's a team there. So change, conditioning. Bring more people will come and there will be a healthy environment. Maybe.
Right. So there is a hope. So according to you, what do you think, what are the things one should do right now so that there is a future improvement, a positive improvement regarding women empowerment in our society?
I would say starting from home. Like at my home, I have a younger brother, but I was given more preference than him. So I've never seen being, you know, suppressed, I would say. I was always the person who was oppressing my brother. So yeah, so now, but you see, it's conditioning. So my family conditioned in that period, I had full power on everything, you know, full say, I want this, I want that, all my decisions. So if we start from here, the conditioning, so we grow up and the same thing happened to our kids, so they will not have this problem. Right. If my mother-in-law doesn't let me work, I will not let my daughter-in-law work. The mentality, see?
So true.
The same. If a brother says that her sister is not allowed to go out, when he will become father, he'll not let his daughter to go out. It's conditioning. It starts at home. So I feel charity begins at home. If you see at home that there is a healthy environment, there is a home. So it's us.
That's so true. So looking at your, coming back to your profession again, so do you think your profession is, I know you are managing a lot of things together, you are taking people here together, you're organizing treks, you are planning it, you are handling the team even in the times of crisis and all those things. So do you think, according to you, what are the things which management has a role to play in your profession?
In my profession, we have people from different social backgrounds. Mm-hmm. My staff is from a different background. My clients are totally from different backgrounds. They together in one space. And, you know, in high altitude, you become cranky also. It's a bad weather condition. So managing those two people from different backgrounds is, you know, I have to make them safe together. My staff is safe with the clients. You know, they are not being rude to them. And my clients say with my staff, okay, they're gonna give them food, you know. So there's, because sometimes my staff cannot speak English. They can understand, but they might not. So, you know, telling my clients to be comfortable with them, you know, behave with them the way they want. And my staff to be friendly to them and not being rude. Because in cities, we have a certain way of living, you know. We can't handle someone saying, you kar de, you know. That is like very rude to them. So yeah, so making them home together is I try to do, so that going back everyone is happy. When you are happy, you do work more, you know. The clients will go happy. So I try to manage that part, having different backgrounds.
So you're trying to manage the differences amongst your people you're working with.
Yeah.
You're getting a balance at your workplace, or whether it's a trek or at an office, at an organization office setup, or anywhere, it is important, right? So what are the things every management student should learn from your profession?
That I feel everybody has their own baggage and their background. So when they come to a space, they carry it. So we have to make sure not judging a person in their first go, because they have their own story. They might not be physically appealing, but they might have a lot of knowledge. Like my guides, they don't look, they are very smart or something, but they are pro in mountains. So sometimes you miss just thinking, oh, ise kya hi aata hoga. But they are the one who will rescue you if something happens. So, you know, not judging, and because everybody has their own experience, we should take time in understanding a person's background and using their skills to the best use.
Right.
Like my guide can't be the cook and my cook can't be the guide. They have their own skill set. Knowing them and using it to the full power.
Yes, yes. Using your employees' potential to its highest and getting the best productivity you can. So every management student should learn from this. So, okay. So lastly, one line of motivation for everybody watching this video right now.
This is not the end.
Right. Being a trekker, I was expecting this motivation guidance from you. That is so obvious. Okay. So one thing that you would suggest every student, whether he or she is in school or maybe doing a PhD or bachelor's or whatever. One thing everybody should keep in mind choosing their career.
It should come from your heart. You should be happy.
Mm-hmm.
In the end, you know, even there are many people who have left their job to become trek leader because they are not happy. In the end, your heart should be at it. But we are so much bound in just making money with your heart might not be happy. So your heart should be active. You should feel getting up, you know. You should feel like aaj uthna hai aur jana hai. Koi bhi job, you have to like, you know, that waking up spiritually, not like, oh shit, job, you know, you have to go for the work. So even when I have to get up in the middle of the night at 2 for my summits, I'm happy there, you know, because I want to go it. Like, I like it.
Right. So fulfilling your heart and making your heart happy should be a very much go-to goal for everybody in their career. So with this note, we are ending this interview here. Thank you so much. We are so happy to have you with us. Thank you so much for making time for this interview.
Thank you.